Vintage Kids. My name is Miss Jessica and I'm from Vintage Downtown, and I'm going to be bringing our lesson for today. So we're going to continue learning about Advent. Does anybody remember what Advent means? Advent is a season of waiting and preparing for the birth of Jesus. So this year we're going to celebrate by looking at the different places in the Bible that God says, fear not. So do not fear at all is what God is saying. So we spent this past year learning about the kingdom of God and what action in the kingdom of God looks like. So we learned about the kingdom of justice and how the kingdom of justice takes action. So our year's been kind of crazy, right? A lot of things have been happening, and I'm sure there's a lot of times where you might have been scared about what the future is going to look like or what's going to even happen tomorrow or next week, and maybe thought, you know, like, what is going to be coming next? So throughout all of that, God tells us, do not be afraid. And as we study where God reminds us to fear not, let's review what our big question is. So does anybody remember what our big question is? So it's, how is the word of God to be read and heard? Do you remember how? Okay, so with diligence, preparation, and prayer. Can you say those three things? Say diligence, preparation, and prayer. So when we do those things, we accept with faith and we store it in our hearts and we practice it in how we live our lives, right? So as we learn about where in the Bible God tells us to fear not, we may have to read, pray, and store it in our hearts. And we practice it in our lives, but he reminds us to fear not. Okay, so let's open up our Bible. We're going to be in the New Testament. So that's the second half of the Bible. So go to book Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 28. And this is what it says. It says, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin promised to be married to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. And the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you. But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to figure out what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will become pregnant and have a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. And he will be great, and he will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And all of his kingdom, there will be no end. And Mary said to the angel, how will this be? And the angel answered her, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be called Holy, the Son of God. And behold, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also gotten pregnant with a son, for nothing will be impossible with God. And Mary said, behold, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word. And the angel left her. Okay, if you want to pause and you can go back and reread that story really quick, we're going to have a few questions. So this is our first question. What does the angel say to Mary? So yeah, he says, do not be afraid. And then he said, you're going to have a son. Why do you think the angel had to tell her, do not fear? Do you think it was scary to see something just so bright and so magical and majestic and just like, wow? It probably scared her. She had never seen anything before like this. And then to be told that she was going to be pregnant with a son, that was a lot. I'm sure she was pretty scared. Okay, and she was also scared because she wasn't married to Joseph yet. So do you think that she was worried about what people might think? I think so. And there was also going to be a lot of things changing in our life. So what news did the angel bring to Mary? And how did this good news affect his life? These are some questions that you can think about and talk about with your parents. And how does this relate to us now? So last week we talked about having fears and how this is normal. Can you guys think of some things that you're scared of? Or times that you might be afraid? It's completely normal for us to have things that we're scared of. But what does God tell us? He tells us to not be afraid, right? And to trust God when we have our fears. So Joseph, he was scared too, right? Joseph had to trust God that his plans were going to change, right? And he had to trust God that Mary was carrying the Son of God. Yeah, there was a lot of different things that they were afraid of in this time. But they had to keep remembering that they had Jesus. Well, they were going to be having Jesus, that they had God. And that God is who they need to trust in all their fears. So I hope you guys have a great week. And if you have any questions about this, you can talk to your parents or your brothers and sisters or your grandparents or friends. And you can ask questions and maybe talk about some of the things that you're afraid of and things that you need to trust God with. So I hope you guys have a great week, and I can't wait to see you.